color bin, raising the electric and change in gender stability. This system is applied to data on gender, media, and society. The structure will help you understand how things portray gender and how it needs to be set. Film is the most influential medium since its invention, and the impact of cinema is visible in almost all culture and society. Film's role in society is not only as a medium of entertainment, but also in cultural, social, political, regional, lingual, and psychological life. This makes films different from other media of mass communication. There are image literature which suggests that the film has always been a powerful medium, and its portrayal of society brings out the harmonic patterns of social structure in any society. This is true, especially of mainstream popular cinema, which reflects the dominant culture codes and shapes the sensibility of a social being. As we move onto the building of identity, cultural studies stress the impact of these prevalent codes of behavior and social structures in every society. The understanding of identities in films are very important as it represents the corresponding culture. The motive of filmmaker producer is can also be uncovered by observing the identities represented in the film. For example, the representation of Indian slums in the film Slumdog Millionaire of 2008 have been considered as problematic. Both film critics and reviewers keep an eye on the representation of identities in cinema in order to examine the achievement, distinctiveness, and quality of the film or the lack of it. The identities are portrayed in films in many ways: cultural, national, regional, religious, racial, gender, and lingual are prominent ways of portraying identity. Katharina Hinton, in his essay, The Epistematic Status of Cultural Identity, states that identities are theoretical constructions that enable us to read the world in specific ways. And then, until then, we learn to define and reshape our values and our commitments. We give our perspective and form to our collective creation. We said this in 2011. Film as a medium of great worldly power enjoys the status of being the mouthpiece to the dominant social group and hence remains problematic as a narrative. The signification process involved in this narrative style exposes the deep structural hierarchies running through the social system. So, intercollect is heavily coded structure and it opens the possibility of multiple readings. This was first upon the Alcazar in 1970. Interpolation then happens aims at building identities by hailing the individuals towards the dominant ideologies perpetuated in the The understanding and study on gender representation and portrayal in film is very crucial as it works in society on three different levels. The population, which gratifies audience of all categories, includes notions of gender portrayal through the film. The gender portrayal in all five films takes inspiration from its subject from real life situations and allows circumstances in the society. A film represents a culture or a nation. A film becomes the media text for that particular nation, which will be used for orientation for further studies. Historical accounts, we will begin by understanding the historical context of gender and film. From its day of commencement, films were criticized and argued as dominated by male thoughts and beliefs. The introduction of viewership the pleasure of a being responsible by certain things. But this argument was tempered by faith itself to an extent. Law was done to a loom, a cryptonym, is landing on the two strings, silencing, directed by Dorothy and Law. This is considered as first medical trick. It is closely watched gender control in the same to fairly mainly reveals around male astronauts who are disengaged. On the other hand, female children are special organs to witness the departure of the astronauts. But once, significant findings state that the role of marines to trigger the rocket to moon is played by women sailors testing. This argues that attempts were on from early days to represent women in space. The case of women currently still is more interesting. The first feature film, Raja Harrison, which was made way back in 1930 by Dada Saab Phalke, had both male and female characters. During the same meeting, the trio found it difficult to get a female actress who is ready to act. Due to social stigma and taboo acting, acting before the camera was considered as unrefined so that women from every class were safe to act. Later on, the director used males to masquerade as females during filming. Later, films like The Phantom, which came up in 1937, had strong female voices and convention. And parallel lines, the female bodies were used as bliss in popular film. Gender studies in film. Let's now learn about gender studies thinking. The gender studies came as a result of several women's liberation movements during the 1960s to 1970s, and it entered into the realm of film studies around the same time, as Hostel Scott in 1974. But film and West Wallet in Oxford School of Film Studies noted that gender issues have been prominent in film studies since the 1970s, when roles in myths and stereotypes of women, men, and films began to be seriously addressed. This was a result in 2003. Since a large portion of this work was considered under the aegis of feminist politics, it viewed itself as prevalently with women. They extend the argument that feminist work on images of women and female stereotypes deeply morphed into theorizations of women as spectacle, and the view that in classical Hollywood films, the female figure on the screen is constructed preeminently as an object to be looked at. There is no surprise that gender studies is overawed by feminist studies. In any case, the questions into men and manliness and films started in early 1980s. These grew for most part on the ideas and strategies for cultural studies. In the course of development in the field, the gender studies in cinema carried over with other traditions of film studies like psychoanalytic film theory, post-structuralist film theory, queer theory, and reception. The gender studies in films are considered as important area in any field of media studies. The need and importance of gender studies in film text can be understood from the following points. Understanding the social development of sexual orientation and the connection amongst sex and emotional ideas, for example, are part of formulativity, generation, cultural, and education. Information of significant history and flow in gender orientation. Learning of the historical transformation of gender-specific roles on the screen. Learning of gender-specific working conditions in films. Understanding the connection between sex, sexual orientation, and education. The positive as well as subversive measurements of this relationship. à notre association, le Father Connection and Presence. Comprehension of the transaction amongst paper and society. I see the presentation of this presentation, introduction of this relation, a sexual orientation, sex relations, and the effect. The interdisciplinary view of gender studies. Soon as a cabinet, the popular media and focus also gave decent space for gender disclosures in children. In Indian film studies scenario, it is important to understand the difference between popular commercial cinema and art film. Because the representation and portrayal of various identities are socially, politically, and aesthetically constructed. When art house films focus on political correctness of portrayal, popular masala films try to reproduce popular beliefs and stereotypes of gender identity. Judith Butler, in her work, The Psychic Life of Power, spoke of female experience and the oppressive patterns evolving under the female identity as conceived and operated by the patriarch. Identities cannot be accurate representation of the real colors, but intercolation happens by hegemonic structure. People respond to it, especially oppressed ones, perhaps because it recognizes them as a group. This was first by Butler in 1997. Butler's concept of performativity elucidates that identity conceptualized, created, and perpetuated by society. Performativity is not a single act, but a repetition of a ritual which achieves its effect through its naturalization in the context of the body and the state, in part as a culturally sustained temporary duration. Women portrayal in film. We will now understand how women are portrayed in film. The work of feminist film theoretician Clara Johnson is considered as an important work in studying women in film. She remarked that despite the enormous emphasis placed on women as spectacle in the cinema, women as women is largely absent. She remarked this in the year 1972. The critics feel that the true representation of women in film will be found when the film is made from subjectivity of the women. Laura Mulvey is another important figure in film, feminist film studies whose work is popular in contemporary film studies. Her work concentrated in female image, male gaze, and complex understanding of cinema and the social technology of gender. There were only very few women film directors in early stage of filmmaking who sustained the critical and reflective accounts on women portrayal. Dorothy Arden was an early American film director who made her films like Casting for Women in 1927, Sarah and Son in 1930, Working Girls in 1931, The Bride Wore Red in 1937, Dance Girl Dance in 1940. Fatma Begum was the first Indian women director who made her films during the silent and talking era. Her films notably were Bulbul of Pakistan, which was in 1936, and Goddess of Luck in 1939. She also established Victoria Fatma Films in the time where the film production was owned by male dominant studio system. The mainstream films or conventional films are considered as male-oriented, where female is represented through male roles. The tradition is visible in any mainstream film of world cinema. The Hollywood started a tradition of Eurocentric film formula, where a man controls the plot, and the heroine is just placed with the hero for his narrative, and voyeuristic enjoyment of the female object of the game. From Norway in 1975. With rare accidents, the mainstream cinema continued with its formula, where they generated popularity and economic profit. The experimental cinematic tradition, Avant Pierre Gray, in 1917, brought changes in gender roles and representations in Belgium. Its reflection they also found in Indian popular film. The creative liberation from studio and big production house gave screenwriters and directors to pay their cinema to poor vision of social justice. The women characters were given freedom and gave space to perform rather than screen show. Films like Bridges of Tiffany's in 1951, Flashdance in 1953, The Sound of Music in 1955, had strong and appropriate women gender. The shift from realistic women characters in male dominant films to women centric films were also becoming popular after these films. The Indian mainstream film tradition of women theatre also followed the classic Hollywood placing women in objectified places. The effort from Satyajit Ray and other pioneers of Indian parallel film movement portrayed women as women. This is not to say that women got much importance or came center of focus, but women portrayal found meaningful outcomes. The mainstream popular Bollywood and other regional languages like Tamil and Telugu are keeping on reducing the female body to five men long fighting dance or love interest of male protagonists. On the other hand, offbeat parallel movement inspired films to be the strong and relevant characters and films. Meta Patel, Norgis, Sarana Arjun, collects early days to Kangana Ranaut, Rajita Akhtar, Hima Qureshi, Patsy Tanya, and contemporary Indian films are given. Recently, unlike mainstream Bollywood regional films of India, especially Malayalam, Kannada, Bengali, Marathi, have rendered some gender literature. The women-oriented films also focus on liberation of women in stereotyped sexual bondage. The desires of women, their choice of relationship, values, social status, professional attitude, religion, and political voices were portrayed in such films. There were also efforts made to glorify womanhood by giving her a hero-like makeup. The action could have made films try to neutralize gender roles. But the role of these things in meeting goals of feminist politics is doubtful. Men portrayal in film. Since we've already learned about women portrayal in film, let us now learn. How men were portrayed in film. The portrayal of men in movies necessarily revolves around stereotypical representations, such as those of the macho heroes, fighters, and protectors. Unlike the experiments and changes in women's portrayal, the portrayal of men appears to have little reduced. It is also to understand that most of the film plot revolved around the male lead, while the scope of experimentation is limited due to the constraints of mainstream film. The limitation is not only because of the popular viewership, but also credited to economic, social, and political conditions. It is often argued that the main portrayal of stereotype hero is the result of normalizing the reality of male dominance in society. Masculinity is mostly projected in war or action films, where he can conquer or counter the past by using his physical power. The Indian films portrayed male as the leading role. Even though not much experiments have happened in gender roles, but social and political roles have been given changes over the years. Here, portrayal in cinema. You will now learn about it. Human folklore is important. The folklore of human identity revolves around three major pieces. These are the relation and orientation of the filmmaker towards the film, the aesthetical and political production of human folklore, and addressing human issues to the film. The queer movement, which started after 1990s, that resulted in a new queer movement in film culture. When the world cinema is progressing with film shows, blue is the warmest color in the year 2013. The Indian mainstream cinema not only is neglecting the issues of queer, but portraying them in dark and negative shades. Coming up this lecture, we learn that films come with ridiculous notions of gender. The women characters are often stereotyped as physically weak, submissive, emotional, dependent, nurturing, helpful, afraid, victim, offended, accepted. And on the other hand, men are shown as physically strong, aware, rational, independent, brave, problem-solving, leaders, and strong. It is very important to overcome this gender stereotyping in order to promote meaningful change. The following measures can be taken for ensuring and promoting gender equality in film. These measures should be taken from educational and professional level. Training and monitoring needs. Developing gender monitoring manual and setting it at regular intervals. Promoting research in gender and cinema and sharing it with students and families. Encouraging gender sensitive film programs. Using and promoting gender neutral rhetoric and language. Hope you enjoyed this lecture. For more details, please read the e-text of this lecture properly and attend the questions in the email. Thank you.